In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make this ice cube typography effect in Adobe Firefly. Stay tuned and I'll show you how.
Studio Shepherd.
So in Adobe Illustrator, I have my artboard set to 1920 by 1080. And we're going to start by selecting the type tool. And I'm going to add my first letter, which is W for water. And I'm going to change the font to Kofo Sans, which I'll link the download to in the description below. Now I'm also going to give it a black stroke and bump that up just to make it a little bit bolder. And then I'm just going to tweak its position and copy it by holding Alt click. And I'm going to add the rest of the letters and position them like this. And I'm going to nudge them into the center of the artboard. So once you're finished and happy, we're going to go up to File, down to Export As, and we're going to save it as a JPEG, making sure to click Use Artboards. Now jumping across into Adobe Firefly, we're going to use this prompt here, melting ice cube with trapped air bubbles, water droplets, and a thin reflective puddle. Then click Generate, and it's going to come up with four options. Now we're just going to change a few of the settings. So I'm going to select Hyper-Realistic, change the lighting to Studio Light, and the camera angle to Shot from Above. And I'm just going to add on the prompt, Isolated on a Studio Background. And then click Generate, and let's see how this looks. So very similar, so we're going to make a few more changes to our prompt. So I've selected Shot from Above, but we're still not getting that effect. So in the prompt, I'm just going to add Top View. And I'm also actually going to change the studio background to a light blue. And then click Generate. Now this is looking a lot better. So I'm liking the look of this top right one. And I think it's going to work well. So I'm happy with that, so I'm going to download that for later. And also clicking this pencil, we can use this as the style reference. So in the left hand panel, we're going to adjust a few more settings. So we're going to change this to widescreen 16:9 to match our canvas. And then we're going to go down to the composition reference and select our image that we made before. So add that in, press continue here. And we're going to bump up the strength slider to full. And then under style, we're going to drop that one to 0. Now the rest of these settings are still looking good, so we're just going to go and hit generate. Now I think these look great first time round, so we can click to have a closer look. And I think this has really nailed the look that I was going for. So once you're happy, we can go upscale all. And that's going to render these as hyper realistic images. And that's how to make this realistic ice cube typography effect using Adobe Firefly. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest design tips. I'll see you in the next video.